Hi viewers, welcome to Guru Globe YouTube channel. This is the second part of video on first chapter in political science, the problems of India and their solutions. So in this video, you will learn about the important problems of India like corruption, discrimination and communalism. Student, in our previous video, you have learned or you have known about the unemployment. And in this video, you will know about the corruption. Corruption, now it is a very important and very severe problem which is giving a lot of trouble to Indian economy and also the society. So it has spread to all the stratas of the society. Here strata means the stages or fields. Nowadays we can say that most of the fields are suffering from the corruption. There are many reasons are there behind of this problem. Before going to know the reasons or causes, first we should understand the meaning of corruption. So according to textbook, it is given that, and you also should write to this answer for one mark question. Corruption means offering bribe and following any other illegal means to achieve some illegal benefits. So this is what we call your corruption. Here offering bribe means giving bribe means that is illegal money, taking money to do the work in illegal way. Okay, so in Kannada what we call it is lancha, and following any other illegal means and any other illegal ways to achieve some illegal benefits, not legal, illegal benefits. So this is what we call here corruption. And corruption also defined or termed as misuse of public authority for personal gain. Misuse of public authority. Public authority means the power which is given to a servant or to a person to do the public work. It is what we call here public authority. Sarvajanika adhikara anta karitina. So public authority for personal gains means for self-interest, for selfish. Vaiktika swarthakkagi kottantaha adhikaravanna durbalake madakottu. Durupayogavagutta. It is. And it can be tells like this: sweeping away all the procedures for narrow personal. Yes, whatever the procedures are there, legal procedures for doing anyone work, just keeping away all those procedures and following any other means a shortcut route or illegal route to getting personal profit. So this is what we call here corruption. Okay, so this corruption, it is negatively affecting on our Indian economy and on our society, and it is also the feature of decaying the ethics in human who are following the corruption. Okay, so here, what are the forms of corruption? Usually we say that if we give the money to anyone's servant or public servant for our work in illegal way, we call this corruption. Yes, that is right. But there are other forms. That's what is listed here. The first one, bribery, lancha. Another one, nepotism. Nepotism means considering someone person as his religion or his caste person and doing his work for the his doing his first work means giving first priority to his work among the citizens or among the people. This is what we call nepotism. In Kannada we call it is swajana pakshapata antariti. Okay, that is one. Another one, caste favoritism. And another one, intentional slowdown of work. Yes, the corrupted people, what they do? Yes, they intentionally slow down the work. ಬೇಕುಂತಲೇ ಉದ್ದೇಶಪೂರ್ವಕವಾಗಿ ಕೆಲಸ ನಿಧಾನ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ ಅವರು. ದೇರ್ ಇಸ್ ನೋ ನೀಡ್ ಟು ಸೈನ್ ಫಾರ್ ಅ ಫೈಲ್ ಮೋರ್ ಟೈಮ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಡಸಂಟ್ ಟೇಕ್ 1 hour ಆರ್ 2 hour ಆರ್ 5 hour. ಆಲ್ದೋ ವಾಟ್ ದೇ ಡೂ, ನಾಟ್ ಆಲ್, ಸಮ್ ಪೀಪಲ್, ಓಕೆ, ಸಮ್ ಸರ್ವೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ದೇ ಡೂ ಇಟ್. ದೇ ಆಸ್ಕ್ ಅಸ್ ಟು ಕಮ್ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಡೇ, ಟು ಕಮ್ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ವೀಕ್. ಹಿಯರ್ ಇಟ್ ವಾಟ್ ಇಟ್ ಶೋಸ್ ಅಸ್ ಯೋ, ದೇ ಆರ್ doing work slowly by intention, uddeshpurukavagi kelasa nidhana martakuru, showing the laziness. When the people will pay the money, will give the money to them in illegal way, then they do that work. So this is what we call here intentional slowdown of work. And another one, tax evasion, means cheating tax. Then another one is there, this is illegal hoarding. Illegal hoarding, okay, means storing the goods in illegal way. Illegal hoarding. Iga akrama dastanu akkiyannu vashapadisikollagide anta news alli kuttirtare. Ration akkiyannu mattondu akkiyannu ration eno akramavagi dastanu maadittare. That is illegal hoarding. Smuggling, I think all of you know the meaning of it. Smuggling, economic offenses. Yes, cheating. So then another one, what's that, the violation of international exchange. Then employment cheating also. Yes, some people are there, they cheat others by offering job and taking money. Okay, by taking money, this is what we call here cheating in the time of employers, that offering the employment. So this is what we see here. Okay, and what are the reasons for corruption? The important 6 reasons are there, students. These reasons may be asked you in exam for 3 marks. For 3 marks, the question may be asked you, what are the reasons for corruption? What are the reasons? The first one is there, that is human selfless. Another one, calculating uncertainty elimination. Then third one, that is personal profit. Then the fourth one, that is lack of strict supervision. The fifth one, a weak legal system. Then sixth one, that is the lack of moral and humanity values. Okay, so these 6 reasons are there, and 6 reasons are for the corruption. Okay, yes. Then the question may be asked you in exam, the reasons of corruption like this way. See, 3 questions are there. 3 questions, meaning is same. Okay, the meaning is that the reasons for corruption. The question asked like this. The first question is that what are the reasons for corruption? The second question, why corruption is widely spread all social strata and universal? Then the third one question, in same question, it is asked which are the factors are motivating the corruption. Okay, so 3 questions, 1 answer. You should know the meaning of question, because in exam they may be asked you, they may be twist the question. So that's why this form is given for your study purpose, one thing. Okay, next, so what are the remedies for corruption? The first one, ethical political leadership. Means here, the people should elect the good persons in election. A good person only can give the good administration. We should elect the ethical neetivantaha vyaktiyanna now aayke madbeku, and good officers, the officers who are there in government, those officers should be good. They should not follow corruption. They should not take the bribe here. That's meaning. And politically aware and educated people can weed out the corruption. Yes, we the people, we should be aware and we should educate the people to fight against the corruption. First, we should take a strong decision that we must not give the bribe. ನಾವು ಯಾವುದೇ ಕಾರಣಕ್ಕೂ ಲಂಚ ಕೊಡಲ್ಲ ಅಂತ ಒಂದು ನಾವು ಗಟ್ಟಿ ಪ್ರತಿಜ್ಞೆ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು. ದೇರ್ ಆರ್ ಸಮ್ ಪೀಪಲ್ ಆರ್ ದೇರ್ ದೇ ಓನ್ಲಿ ಆಸ್ಕ್ ಟು ಟೇಕ್ ದ ಮನಿ ಟು ಸಮ್ ಆಫೀಸರ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಪಬ್ಲಿಕ್ ಸರ್ವೆಂಟ್ ಆರ್ ದ ಆರ್ ಅದರ್ ಸರ್ವೆಂಟ್ಸ್. ನಮ್ಮಲ್ಲೇ ಕೆಲವರು ಏನು ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಪ್ಪ, ನಾವೇ ಮುಂದೆ ಹೋಗಿಸೋದು ತೋರಿ, ಒಂದು 100 500 ತೋರಿ, ನಮ್ಮ ಕೆಲಸ ಮಾಡಿಕೊಡು ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತೀವಿ. ನೋ, ಯು ಶುಡ್ ನಾಟ್ ಡೂ ಇಟ್. ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಒನ್ ಥಿಂಗ್. And another one is that to implement Lokapala and Lokayukta properly. It is already implemented. But the government should give lot of powers to Lokapala and Lokayukta. So Lokapala, it is in central level, and Lokayukta, it is in state level. Anti-corruption institutions which are established as per the guidelines of articles of Indian constitution. This is one. Okay, another one is that CCTV cameras should be installed in all government offices. So if the CCTV cameras are installed, then the servants, they won't show the dare to take the bribe. This is one. And another one, harsh punishment can be given to the servants who are taken the corruption. ಈಗಷ್ಟೇ ಒಂದೇನೊಂದು ಲಂಚ ತೊಗೊಂಡಪ್ಪ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಒಂದು 200 500 ಒಂದು 5000 to 10000 ಪನಿಷ್ ಫೈನ್ ಹಾಕಿದ್ರೆ ಹಿ ಆರ್ ಶಿ ವಿಲ್ ಪೇ ಇಟ್. ಬಟ್ ಇಫ್ ದ ಪನಿಷ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಗಿವನ್ ದೆಮ್ ಲೈಕ್ 6 months ಆರ್ 1 year 2 years ಇಂಪ್ರಿಸನ್ಮೆಂಟ್, ದೆನ್ ದ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಡೇ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಟೈಮ್ ದೇ ವೋಂಟ್ ಶೋ ದ ಡೇರ್ ಟು ಟೇಕ್ ದ ಬ್ರೈಬ್. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಇವನ್ ಅದರ್ ಸರ್ವೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ದೇ ವೋಂಟ್ ಶೋ ದ ಡೇರ್ ಟು ಟೇಕ್ ದ ಬ್ರೈಬ್. ಇಸ್ಟ್ ನ Yes, this is one. And another one is that to increase the number of courts. This is very important here. Increase the number of the courts and judges. However, we increase the number of courts, then those courts will hear cases which related to the corruption and give the judgment. Here the judgment should be rapid. But bega shigravagi nyaya tirmana kodutakkantadagabeku. So these are the remedies are here. And the question may be asked you in exam like this on the remedies. The first question, that is, what are the measures taken by government to eradicate the corruption? The question. The same question may be asked you like, how do you suggest for the elimination of corruption in India? Okay, so the questions are here. Better you take it down in your notebook and write the answer what I have showed you here. Okay, this is the answer for these questions. Understood now? Good. Next, there are public servants in India can be imprisoned for several years and penalized for corruption under the several sections are there and laws are there. So those are the first one, that is Indian Penal Code 1860. And the prosecution section of Income Tax Act 1961. Then another one, that is the Prevention of Corruption Act 1988. This is the fourth one, that is the Benami Transaction Act of 1988. Then the fifth one, that is the Prevention of Money Laundering Act 2002. And another one is that the Lokapala and Lokayukta Act 2013. So these acts, laws are implemented for weeding out the corruption in India. Okay, so this is one thing. And the political corruption is an opportunity to systematic crime. This political corruption, you see that in politics, the corruptions is the adherna, that is systematic crime it is. And it negatively affect on the public and personal gains. One thing. So another one bad effect is here, negative effect on public and personal. Then